It's the Transfer Rater with Ali Moreno for ESPN FC. Here are the latest names in the bag. We start with Gareth Bale going back to Real Madrid. And apparently, this is in case Zinedine Zidane does get sacked and does move on. Apparently, Bale wants to be back there.
Oh, great. Thanks, Gareth. What? You miss the country club? What? You need to go back and play some golf? No. It doesn't work that way, Gareth. You cannot just sit around and mope around like you did for a few years and just complain and you're not getting the playing time that you want or that you deserve or that you're entitled to and have the sort of behaviors that he had over the last couple of years and then say, yeah, I want to go back to Madrid. Hey, nothing to see here. It's all good with Madrid. No, it's not all good with Madrid. It would never work. It didn't work towards the end. And for as many important goals as Gareth Bale scored for Real Madrid in very key moments, what we remember from him is just him kind of snickering, sitting in the stands or sitting on the bench, complaining about not playing, sitting in a golf cart somewhere while his team is playing. All those things that I think have really damaged the reputation and the perception of Gareth Bale. It would not work for him to go back to Real Madrid. It would not make any sense. He better make it work at Spurs. And good luck with that as well.
One player who actually left Spurs to try other places and it hasn't worked out for is Christian Eriksen. And it really does look as though he will be on the move in the January transfer window. The rumour is him to PSG and he would favour a move to PSG over a move back to the Premier League. So what do you say, Ali?
I say Christian Eriksen has to leave Inter right now. Right this second. Just walk out the door, Christian. It is clear that Antonio Conte does not care for Christian Eriksen as a player. And I don't know whatever differences they may have, but it's also clear that Antonio Conte is steadfast and stubborn to the point of not playing Christian Eriksen, even when he needs him out on the field and the game requires it. So it's not going to work. So he's got to leave Inter. Well, if that's PSG, then so be it. But Eriksen has to walk out the door right now.
Is Dele Alli another player who should leave Spurs? Because we're back here again. The transfer window is opening. Dele Alli's name comes back up.
Oh, whatever happened to the cute story of, oh, I got the confidence from Jose Mourinho when he came and told me, are you Dele Alli's brother? And then he got a reaction from Dele Alli and he scored a goal. Oh, my God, everything is great. We're back to normal. Dele Alli's going to be the player that we think he's going to be. No. He's got to go. He's got to go find something else because clearly, again, it's not going to work right now at Spurs.
I'm very interested in what you're going to say to the next one because he was linked with a move to Fenerbahce last week and that's still somewhere there in the rumours. But it's Mesut Ozil to LA Galaxy. There has been talk that he is interested in coming to MLS. Could you see that happening?
Well, I'm sure that he's interested. But for the LA Galaxy, you need to figure out a whole bunch of stuff outside of that position in terms of what Mesut Ozil can give you as a player. Now, talented as he may be, the LA Galaxy right now have holes everywhere. And they have to make all sorts of different decisions in terms of personnel, not just one. And if you invest that sort of money that you would have to invest in order to bring Mesut Ozil, it's going to hamstring you in terms of what you do with the rest of that squad. I don't think right now for the LA Galaxy you go after one player because you need about five or six players and five or six good players, serviceable players that can be very good and productive for you in Major League Soccer. So, no, the holes are too many in the LA Galaxy to just go for one big name.
DC United's been mentioned as well, Ali, there. So maybe we might see him stateside.
They got holes
soon.
Too. Yeah, they got a lot of holes too. So they got to address other needs as well.
All right, last one. This was a bit of a surprise. Frankie de Jong to Bayern. Apparently, they've already shown an interest and they're hoping to take advantage of Barca's current financial situation in the hope that they would offload him.
On the surface, it would be surprising. But when you see Frankie de Jong play for Barcelona, and this is a conversation that we've had over the last few weeks, he's a good player, but not spectacular. Has not been great for Barcelona, has been just solid, just a guy that just kind of connects passes here and there, gives you some work, gives some flexibility through the midfield, but not enough productivity in the attacking half and not necessarily the cleanest in possession of the ball, which you need to be at Barcelona. I expected much more from him at Barcelona. And if Barcelona is looking to open up some cap space, if you will, some money space, then maybe something that makes sense. Although I don't think Barcelona are in a position right now to let go of players they need actually more talent on the field rather than less talent on the field. I don't think this makes sense for Barcelona, and I think Frankie de Jong still has something to give to this team.
Yeah, definitely a few moves and shakers to keep our eyes on in the transfer window.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.